奉主耶稣圣灵说话。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
晚上向我们亚当还有线上的弟兄姐妹来问个晚安。
Firstly, greetings of peace to our brothers and sisters in Adam Road Church and those who are streaming in.
今晚的题目是十诫里面的不可奸淫。
Tonight, our topic is a part of the Ten Commandments. You shall not commit adultery.
记载在出埃及记二十章十四节。
Which is found in Exodus chapter 20, verse 14.
这是神带领以色列人出埃及以后，在西乃这个地方，神借着摩西颁布了十条诫命。
After God had led the people of Israel out of Egypt at the Mount Sinai, God gave the Ten Commandments for the people.
十条诫命，我们教会是认定是跟得救有关系。
In our church, we believe that the Ten Commandments are linked to our salvation.
为什么我们这样的认定呢？
Why are we so sure?
并不是因为我们个人的权威。
It is not because of our own personal opinions.
我们来看马太福音的十九章。
Let us turn to Matthew chapter 19.
马太福音的十九章十六到十七节。
Matthew chapter 19 verses 16 to
17. 读到十九节哈。
Verse 16 to verse 19.
请读。
Matthew chapter 19 verses 16 to 19 verse 16.Now behold, one came and said to him, Good teacher, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? So he said to him, Why do you call me good? No one is good but one, that is God. But if you want to enter into life, keep the commandments. He said to him, Which ones? Jesus said, You shall not murder, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness. Honor your father and your mother, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself.
那这里清楚记载一个少年财主来询问耶稣如何得永生。
Here it is a clear description of how a rich young ruler went to Jesus and asked him how to inherit eternal life.
主耶稣就告诉他说：“你若要进入永生，就当遵守诫命。”
Jesus said to him, "If you want to enter into eternal life, keep the commandments."
少年人就问耶稣说：“什么诫命呢？”
Then a young man asked, "Which ones?"
主耶稣就列出了十诫里面的几个诫命。
Jesus then went on to list several of the Ten Commandments.
其中一个是不可奸淫。
One of which you shall not commit adultery.
那显然的，主耶稣的话是不能更改的。
It is evident that the words of Jesus cannot be changed.
可是为什么今天在基督教界，甚至在有一些个人的想法里面，会认为说，即使犯了诫命也能够得救呢？
Why is it that today, among general Christianity, there are people who say that you can still be saved even though you have committed adultery?
我们知道，一般上讲到，我们会提到成功神学啊。
When we talk in our sermon, sometimes we bring up the topic of the prosperity gospel.
可是还有另外一种神学，我们可能会忽略的。
But perhaps we might not often bring up this other theology.
我们叫做自由主义神学。
Which is also called liberal theology.
这种自由主义神学到底要讲的是什么呢？
So what does liberal theology propound?
他们宣告说神是爱。
They advocate that God is love.
因此，既然神是爱，人所犯的罪，神都会赦免。
And since God is love, God will forgive every sin committed by man.
甚至同性恋。
Even homosexuality.
所以你不要奇怪，在基督教界里面有同性恋的教会、同性恋的牧师。
Therefore, you should not be surprised that there are homosexual churches and pastors.
但是可怕的是什么呢？
But what is more terrifying?
因为这种爱的宣导，在基督神学主义的一个带领之下，很多基督徒也不知不觉被影响了。
Many Christians have been influenced by this.People who propound this teaching of liberal theology.
但是他们受影响，也不是说他们要故意去被影响。
But it is not that these people were deliberately led under its influence.
只是因为他们对圣经的一些解释并不完全的了解。
But it is because they do not fully understand the teachings of the Bible.
人又喜欢高举神的爱。
Furthermore, people like to exalt.God's love.
但是却常常忽略了神的公义。
But they, as a result, they neglect God's righteousness.
所以我们要明白诫命是跟得救有关，千万不要以为说可以犯诫命会被赦免。
Therefore, we need to have a clear understanding that the commandments are intricately linked with our salvation. You shall not commit adultery because you cannot be saved.
我们看马太福音的十九章的前面、哦、
Let's read the former part of Matthew chapter 19.
十九章的三节开始到第九节。
Chapter 19 verses 3-9.
这里 有法利赛人来试探耶稣。
Over here, it describes the Pharisees coming to tempt Jesus.
他们告诉来问耶稣说，人无论什么事都可以、啊、就可以休妻吗？
Or rather, to test Jesus,、whether it is lawful for man to divorce his wife for any reason.、
法利赛人会这样问，是因为在摩西的律法里面。
The Pharisees pose this question because according to the laws of Moses,、
他们是允许休妻的。
Divorce was permitted.、
但是呢，主耶稣在这里却告诉他们。
However, Jesus replied.
第四节说，耶稣回答说，那起初造人的是造男造女。第五节，并且说，因此人要离开父母，与妻子联合，二人成为一体。你们没有念过吗？再接下来八节说，既然如此，夫妻不再是两个人，乃是一体了。所以神配合的人不可分开。主耶稣的回应里面，让法利赛人有点惊讶。
Now Jesus' response caused the Pharisees to be surprised.
因为明明记在律法里面，摩西允许啊。
Because this had been recorded in the law, Moses had permitted it.
所以再下来第七节，他们就问耶稣了，法利赛人就问耶稣了。
And therefore they asked Jesus.
这样摩西为什么吩咐给妻子休书就可以休她呢？
Why then did Moses command to give a certificate of divorce and to put her away?
八节耶稣就告诉他们。
Verse 8, Jesus said to them.
耶稣因为你们的心啊，摩西因为你们的心硬，所以许你们休妻，但起初并不是这样。
Moses, because of the hardness of your hearts, permitted you to divorce your wives, but from the beginning it was not so.
九节耶稣更严厉地告诉他们。
And then in verse 9, he said this very sternly.
凡休妻另娶的，若不是为淫乱的缘故，就是犯奸淫了哈。
Whoever divorces his wife except for sexual immorality and marries another commits adultery.
按照刚才我们的嘛少年财主来问耶稣的话，这是跟永生有关系的。如果犯了这个诫命
，So just like what we read with the rich young ruler, if we break this commandment, then our eternal life will be at stake.
那当时候，这些旧约的以色列人，因为他们心硬，他们就随意的就给了一封休书，就把妻子给休了。
So it was because the Israelites in the Old Testament, were hard-hearted. Therefore, it was permitted for them to have this letter of divorce.
显然的，神并不认同这种做法了。
But we see here that God, does not, esteem this practice.
因为耶稣把他带到起初神创造人的心意。
Because Jesus, cited.The very beginning when God put two together.
我们知道摩西五经是摩西写的。
We know that the five books of Moses were written by Moses himself.
如果我们熟悉希伯来圣经
，If you are familiar with the Hebrew Bible,
第一卷书就是以起初这个名字取名的。
The first book starts off in the beginning.
以这个为名的。
And that is the title.
所以主耶稣很清楚地告诉他们说，在我给颁布。神颁布给这个摩西的律法里面，神的心意就是不可分开。
Therefore, when the law was distributed through Moses, and the will of God was that man let not man separate.
清楚说明了神的心意。
So this revealed, the will of God.
而且警告有妻子以外的第三者就是犯了奸淫。
And this is also a warning, to a third party.To a married couple, and that is committing adultery.
但是我们发现旧约有一件事情，神并没有明文禁止他们的。
But we discovered that there was a record in the Old Testament where God did not forbid them.
他们是可以去娶多个妻子的。
They were able this person was able to marry one more wife.
只要他不去娶别人的妻子，他就不是犯奸淫。
As long as he did not marry.Someone who was already married, then he would not commit adultery.
但是是否神同意这样的做法呢？
But did God, was God agreeable actually with such an action?
生命记的十七章。
Let's read Deuteronomy chapter 17.
生命记十七章十七节。
Deuteronomy chapter 17 verse 17.
请读。
Deuteronomy chapter 17 verse 17.Neither shall he multiply wives for himself, lest his heart turn away, nor shall he greatly multiply silver and gold for himself.
这里神在借着律法告诉以色列人，将来如果你们要立王，
here through the law, God commanded the people that in the future, if they were to make for themselves kings,
这个王要抄律法书，
then the kings, these kings would have to copy the book of the law.
因为要学习敬畏神，
because they needed to learn the fear of God.
这是对神的，
and this was towards God.
对人，神没有允许他们说他不可。这里讲的不可为自己多立妃嫔。
And here it says that he shall not multiply wives for himself.
因此我们看到神的心意始终不要人在这个这种关系上有多的。
Therefore, we see that it is God's will that man should not multiply wives for themselves.
神从来没有同意他们可以有许多的妻子。
And God has never.Allowed for this polygamous marriage.
但是是人在罪败坏以后的结果，心硬偏向邪恶了。
However, it was the consequence of sin where man's heart became evil and they were inclined towards doing evil.
你读创世纪第四章。
When you read Genesis chapter 4,
第一个娶多妻的就是拉麦。
The first person who married more than one, who had more than one wife, was called Lamech.
拉麦娶了两个妻子，在十九节记载。
In Genesis chapter 4 verse 19, it records Lamech taking for himself two wives.
然后我们也知道家谱里面分了一批敬畏神，一批不敬畏神的人。
And in the genealogies that were recorded, there were two lines, one that feared God and one that did not.
一个来自赛特，一个来自该隐。
One was the line of Seth and the other the line of Cain.
这一群不敬畏神的人常常是违背神的旨意。
And the line that did not fear God often went against God's will.
因此我们看到圣经里面提醒神的百姓不可多妻，不可犯奸淫。
Therefore, the Bible repeatedly instructs the people of God are not to commit adultery and not to have multiple wives.
我们再看马拉基书。
Let's also take a look at Malachi.
马拉基书的二章。
Malachi chapter 2.
马拉基书的二章十一十二节。
Malachi chapter 2 verses 11 to 12.Malachi chapter 2 verses 11 to 12 verse 11 Judah has dealt treacherously and an abomination has been committed in Israel and in Jerusalem. For Judah has profaned the Lord's holy institution which he loves. He has married the daughter of a foreign god. May the Lord cut off from the tents of Jacob the man who does this, being awake and aware, yet who brings an offering to the Lord of hosts.
这里提到这些回来重建圣殿的百姓，这五万多人当中的一百多个人。
So here talks about the people who had returned from exile to build to rebuild the city. Of them, there were 100.
他们嫁娶了外邦的女子。
Who had married the daughters of Gentiles?
那他们娶嫁了，这里说他们就亵渎神所喜爱的圣洁。
And here it describes how they had profaned the Lord's holy institution.
因为婚姻本身反映了神与人的关系。
A marriage represents or symbolizes the relationship between God and man.
嫁娶外邦是其中一个，使圣洁的会变成不圣洁。
And to marry a Gentile and unbeliever would be causing something which is holy to be unholy.
圣洁的教训就是要百姓懂得来敬畏神。
And the holy institution or the teachings of holiness, it was for the people to fear God.
他们娶嫁这些外女带来的一个恶行是什么呢？
So as a result of marrying these daughters of Gentiles, what evil deeds had or sins had they done?
从十三节开始记载。
From verse 13,
你们又行了一件这样的事。
Here it records this second thing that which they did.
使前妻叹息哭泣的眼泪遮盖耶和华的坛，以致耶和华不再看顾那供物，也不乐意从你们手中收纳。
You cover the altar of the Lord with tears, with weeping and crying, so he does not regard the offering anymore, nor receive it with goodwill from your hands.
十四节又说，你们还说这是为什么呢？因耶和华在你和你幼年所娶的妻中兼作见证，她虽是你的配偶，又是你盟约的妻，你却以诡诈待她。十五节，虽然神有灵的余力能造多人，他不是单造一人吗？为何只造一人呢？乃是他愿人得前程后裔。所以当谨守你们的心，谁也不可以诡诈待幼年所娶的妻。 那同样的，我们看到神这里很清楚告诉他们说，他恨恶休妻的事情。
And similarly, here describes how God detests divorce.
恨恶啊，十六节记载恨恶啊。
And here verse 16 says that he hates divorce.
神有能力造亚当以后再造一个夏娃。
And God had the power to create an Adam and after that an Eve.
他没有这样做。
But he didn't do it.
他是从亚当身上取出了肋骨来造出夏娃。
Rather, he took a rib from Adam to create Eve.
为了是要强调一体不可分的一种观念。
And to symbolize this concept of one body which should not be separated.
这是神的一个心意。
And this is the will of God.
但是当时的百姓他们娶嫁外邦，就要把妻子给休了。
But the people in this period had married the Gentiles and they wanted to divorce their own wives.
而且以诡诈的心来待他们的幼年所娶的妻。
Furthermore, they dealt treacherously with the wife of their youth.
这幼年的妻就说他们以前娶来的妻子，第一个妻子就对了。
So the wife of their youth would refer to their first wives.
那他们是诡诈的。
And they dealt with them treacherously.
那当然我们看到这里会谈到神的创造啊。
Here also talks, mention God's creation.
或许要阐明一下，说明一下。
So allow me to explain.
因为有些人说男人会少了一根肋骨，因为神从亚当身上取出一个肋骨，造了夏娃。
People say that man has one less rib because God had taken one that rib out to create Eve.
因此男人是少一根肋骨的。
Therefore, people say that, men, the males have one less rib.
可是错误，这是错误的。
But this is erroneous.
因为现在的医学告诉我们，男人从来没有缺少肋骨。
Because medical science, has helped us to understand that there was never a missing rib.
当然有这种说法，是因为他们以为说，神取了肋骨，人的肋骨就不会长了。
But this saying came about because, since God took a rib out of man, therefore that rib would not regrow.
我们知道我们的骨里面有骨膜，你就算断了，它也会长的嘛。
In our ribs can actually regrow even though it may be broken or fractured.
其实这种男人少一根肋骨来自一希腊的一个爱情故事，并不是圣经啊。
So, this saying that man has one less rib, comes out from a love fantasy. It is not biblical.
所以男人女人的肋骨都十二对的，左右对称。
And so therefore, men and women have the same number of ribs.
而且骨头是有重生的能力的啊。
And ribs can be regrown.
不需要任何神迹的。
And it does not require any miracle.
但是从另一个逻辑去想，我们也明白。
But we can also understand this logically.
如果我结婚前发生的车祸少了一条腿。
结婚前。Before I were to marry, I encountered a traffic accident and I lose a leg.
那后来我结婚了，我生小孩了，我的孩子不会因为我而少了一条腿。
And then after I marry, I have children.My children would not have one less leg because of me.
这是题外话哦。但是我要回到我们的这个主题，想说。
Allow me to come back to the topic.
最后要理解一体的关系，强调忠诚圣洁。
Coming back to this concept of one body, holiness is important.
有敬虔后裔，使他们可以敬畏神。
And God seeks godly offsprings that will continue to fear God.
所以我们看到拉麦那个普希里面的人。没有一个敬畏神啊。
So if you look at the line of Lamech, none of them feared God.
那赛特他们是养儿生女就死了，可是拉麦他们是娶妻不断的，最后到第六章创世纪，人多起来人就败坏，随意嫁娶了。
So, when we compare the genealogies of Seth and Lamech or Cain, we see how the line of Cain, or Lamech became increasingly corrupt.
他们也本来求告神的，也跟着这些拉麦他们后面的这些人一样败坏啊。
And even those who called on the name of the Lord also became corrupt.
这些后代也破坏神起初所定的婚姻的制度，因为他们随意嫁娶啊。
Therefore, these descendants had broken the institution of marriage because they married as they saw fit.
所以洪水就来把那一个世代的人给灭了，只有挪亚一家被拯救。
Therefore, the flood came and destroyed that generation apart from Noah and his family.
圣洁的神岂能容忍人如此胡作非为呢？
How can the holy God tolerate this evil doings of men?
因为他们不再尊重神的创造的次序。
Because men no longer respected the proper order of creation.
那在路加福音里面，主耶稣警告。
In the Gospel according to Luke, Jesus also gave a warning.
哦，路加福音的17章26、27节里面。
In Luke chapter 17, verses 26 to 27.
他说：“挪亚的日子怎么样，人的日子也要怎么样。”十七、二十七节，我眼睛有点不大看得到。二十七节，那时候的人又吃又喝，又嫁又娶，到挪亚进方舟的那日，洪水就来把他们全灭了。主耶稣引述了挪亚跟罗德他们当时候被神用水跟火毁灭的一个事件。
So Jesus here.Cited the example of Lot and Noah, and as for Noah, how he entered the ark and the flood came and destroyed the people.
当时的门徒也警告我们，今天末世的时候，当这个世界降败坏的时候，神也照样要降的来毁灭这个世界。
It was a reminder and warning to the disciples then and to us today that in the last days, God will also destroy the world because of their wickedness.
罗德的世代他们有什么这么大的罪恶呢？
So what were the evils that were committed in the days of Lot?
哦，他们不以淫乱为耻啊。
It was not only their sexual immorality.
哦，他们已经进到不只是多妻这个问题，是同性恋了
哦。Not only did they commit the sin of polygamy, they also committed the sin of homosexuality.
哦，但是我们知道，你违背神的创造带来的后果，其实就是不好的。
And we know that if you go against this order of God's creation, then the consequences would be dire.
其实很多那些同性恋到最后他们自杀啊。
There are a number or there are many people who are homosexuals who might end their lives by committing suicide.
因为他们本身都大部分都是不忠诚的。
Because many of them, they are not loyal.
而且已经习以为常了。
And to them, it is a natural thing to do.
那我们这个世代其实是越来越邪恶的世代啊。
And this generation is increasingly becoming more and more wicked.
几个月前，如果你有看新加坡的新闻，
if you read the news in Singapore a few months ago,
你很难想象竟然有换妻的俱乐部。
It will be hard to imagine that there's such a club where they would exchange their wives.
甚至说有一些丈夫会用迷药去迷了昏他的妻子，然后叫一群人来彼此迷奸彼此的妻子。
There were even men, husbands, who drugged their wives, and while their wives were unconscious, they invited other men to have to commit sexually immoral acts with her.
被告上法庭啊。
And so these people were brought to court.
有些还不认罪。
And there were some who did not acknowledge.
这个世代已经进到一种变态无耻的一种行为里面了。
Therefore, we see how the world is becoming more and more perverse.
所以作为基督徒，我们要谨慎。
Therefore, as Christians, we need to be watchful.
这个世代有很多错误的观念错误的行为也会影响基督徒的。
There are many erroneous teachings and behaviors that will influence us Christians.
主耶稣警告我们。
Jesus warns us.
马太福音第五章。
In Matthew chapter 5.
马太福音第五章。
Matthew chapter 5.
27-30节。
Verses 27 to 30. Matthew chapter 5, verses 27 to 30. Verse 27. You have heard that it was said to those of old, you shall not commit adultery. But I say to you that whoever looks at a woman to lust for her has already committed adultery with her in his heart. If your right eye causes you to sin, pluck it out and cast it from you.For it is more profitable for you that one of your members perish than for your whole body to be cast into hell. And if your right hand causes you to sin, cut it off and cast it from you. For it is more profitable for you that one of your members perish than for your whole body to be cast into hell.
主耶稣说，凡看见妇女就动淫念的，这个人心里已经与她犯奸淫了。
Jesus said that he who looks at a woman to lust for her has already committed adultery in his heart.
怎么样定义叫做犯奸淫呢？
So how do we define committing adultery then?
付出了行动才算吗？
Is it only after the commission of the act?
还是心里面有这种意念，我们叫做一种意念了，就开始犯了。
Or does it refer to the intention, the thought that arises in one's heart?
我们众所周知，罪没有一件不是从心开始的。
So all sin comes from our heart.
所以雅各书一章十五节讲得很清楚。
Therefore, James chapter 1 verse 15 puts it clearly.
私欲既怀了胎。
That when desire has conceived,
就会生出罪来。
It gives birth to sin.
罪既长成。
And sin, when it is full grown,
就会生出死来。
Brings forth death.
罪是心的问题。
Therefore, it is a matter of the heart.
耶稣警告我们。
Jesus warns us.
哦，不要以为说你没有付出行动，神就不知道。
Do not say that you have not committed any action because God already knows.
也不要以为说心里面有这个业没有犯，你就会没事。
And do not think that as long as you harbor these thoughts without any action, then that is fine.
因为人没有犯罪的机会，有时候是没有犯罪的机会啊。
Because sometimes it is because there is an absence of opportunity to commit sin.
但是有机会的时候，可能人就会去犯了啊。
But if such opportunities arise, then there is a high probability that one will commit sin.
神是在看人的心的。
God sees the hearts of men.
如果有时候你没有机会，你不去犯；有机会，很可能你就会去做了。
So if there is no opportunity, you cannot commit sin. If there is an opportunity, there is a high likelihood you would.
所以不要这么的简单的认为，只有付出的行动才是罪，心里想的就不是罪。
So do notThink so simply that just because you do not have any actions, therefore to just have that thought is not sin.
主耶稣看得更深远
啊。Because the Lord Jesus goes even deeper.
他没有停留在肤浅的社会的约束力上。
He does not only want to address the superficial nature of things.
那种约束力哈。
Or this
约束，我约束你。
Control.
我限制你。他是看透了人的心。
Or this sense of self-control, because God looks at our hearts.
那重点是律法神的这个天国的律法呢，注重在我们内心。
So therefore, God's laws, they all have to do with our hearts.
但是我们常常会听到有人这样讲啊。
But often we also hear people say this.
我也有看女孩子啊。
I do look at women.
我也看到漂亮英俊的男孩子啊。
I do look at handsome men.
难道我闪过一个意念，那我就是犯了奸淫了吗？
Does it mean that just one glance that would mean I've committed sin?
尤其在这个时代。
Especially in this generation.
你想不看，他们偏偏穿得很暴露给你看。
You say you do not want to see, but people around are wearing so revealing outfits.
他要你好看。
They want to be seen.
你不知不觉就一直看。
And then you unknowingly continue to see.
那你是否已经犯了奸淫了呢？
Does that mean that you have committed adultery?
当然还不至于。
This is not only so.
因为你戴上眼镜，太阳眼镜蒙住眼出门吗？难道？
Does that mean that you can wear sunglasses and go out blind?
其实罪是心的问题。罪是心的问题。
The sin is in fact a matter that concerns the heart.
那如果我们的心不约束，
and if we do not restrain or control our hearts,
即使你是瞎眼，你也会想，好不好？
Then even though you may be blind, your thoughts will still wander.
你知道以前的中国的太监，他们也会找女人啊。
Even the eunuchs of ancient China, they also will look for women.
你说他们被阉了，为什么他们还要找呢？
You say that they have been castrated, but why do they still go?
因为他的心里面就是有这种欲望。
Because there is desire in their hearts.
但是我们要了解主耶稣在这里讲的，你看妇女就是动淫念。
What we need to understand is that when Jesus here says that if you look at a woman to lust for her,
他这里的意思是说你是不断的看，目不转睛的，不是只是单纯的去看一看而已。
It does not refer to an unintentional glance, but rather a deliberate look and deliberately paying attention.
是我们用一句话是色眯眯的去看。
You look at the person with lecherous eyes.
女孩子一定很敏感的嘛。
And so the ladies will be more sensitive.
尤其是漂亮的女孩子啦。
Or rather, you will be more attracted to the more beautiful ladies.
你一定会遇到外面有一些男人，他就是从头到尾好像要把你看穿这样的。
You would observe that there are some men outside who want to who are as if examining your whole body.
你走到哪里，他盯到哪里去啊？
Wherever you go, they will stare.
当然也很可能，如果你穿得太暴露，也会引发这样的问题啊。
But of course, it could be an issue with your attire because if that is too revealing, then this problem will happen.
但是主耶稣讲的，这是一种你心怀淫念的一个注视着看。
But what Jesus here is emphasizing is that there is lust in your heart that causes you to intentionally pay attention.
哦，这种看是你已经要付出行动了。
And this form of looking already precedes taking an action.
彼得长老有一段形容得很好。
And Elder James has this very apt description.
Elder Peter.
Oh, sorry, Elder Peter.
彼得后书二章。
In 2 Peter.
二章十四节。
2 Peter chapter 2 verse 14.
彼得后书二章十四节。
Second Peter chapter 2 verse 14, verse 14. Having eyes full of adultery that, and that cannot cease from sin, enticing unstable souls, they have a heart trained in covetous practices and are accursed children.
所以当时候使徒的教会里面就有一些这样的人。
So there were people in the apostolic church.
他们满脸是银色，止不住 不住犯罪的哈。
Whose eyes were full of adultery that cannot cease from sin.
他会去引诱那些心不坚固的人。
And they entice those who are unstable.
因为他们已经太习惯犯罪了。
Because they were so used to committing sin.
所以他们这种就是不只是心的问题，他会付出行动的。
Therefore, it was not only in their hearts, but it had already come out through their actions.
但是彼得长老说，这些人都是被咒诅的种类哈。
Peter here described them as accursed children.
所以那个这个是在我们面对很多的这些诱惑。
So in this day and age.We will encounter many temptations.
现在手机随时打开来，你要看什么都可以。
With your smartphone, just turn it on and you can look at anything you want.
如果你沉迷在这些，你不断的去看，习惯了你就成了上瘾。
And if you're glued to your screen, it may develop into an addiction.
你最后就会化为一个行动去做。
And that addiction will cause you to take actions.
主耶稣的意思不是说你只是瞧一眼哦。
So Jesus does not.Only mean that you you taking a quick glance.
这种看是有动机，是刻意的。
But rather, it is a very intentional form of looking with a motive.
不只是闪过一个念头这么简单了。
And not as simply as a quick glance.
如果每一个闪个念头就是犯罪，那我们每个人就很危险了。
Because if he was referring to any quick glance, then we will all be in danger.
每天都要悔改咯。
Then every day you have to ask for forgiveness.
每一刻都要悔改咯。
Every moment you have to ask for forgiveness.
那当然这也不是不好啦哈，但是主耶稣并不是这样的意思了哈。
And so it is in a way it is not good, but this is not what Jesus meant.
只是我们要从内心里面去管制我们的心。
And the crux of the matter is that we have to learn to control and restrain our hearts.
马太福音的十五章。
In Matthew chapter 15.
十九节。
Verse 19.
马太福音的十五章十九节。
Matthew chapter 15 verse 19. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies.
那主耶稣谈到人的心里面哈。
Here Jesus was talking about man's heart.
这些从心里面出来的都会污秽人。
And these are the things coming out from the heart that defiles a person.
但是我们要从主耶稣从我们的内心开始，要我们去对付罪来看。
But we have to examine our hearts.
如果你心里隐藏罪，而且乐在其中，那你要小心了。
If we have hidden sins in our hearts and we rejoice in them, then we need to be careful.
因为神知道你的意念。
Because God knows our thoughts.
主耶稣要求他的门徒要达到他的公义圣洁的标准。
Jesus expected his disciples to attain to the level of holiness which he demanded.
在马太福音那个说你看妇女你动一念里面，他讲了一个很重要的八福的清心的人有福了。
So in Matthew,
chapter 5,
chapter 5, in the Sermon on the Mount, in the Beatitudes, Jesus mentioned, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
清心的意思是内心不要隐藏罪。
So being pure in heart means that you do not hide any sins or evil in your heart. 不要
滋生恶念。
You do not harbor evil thoughts in your heart.
这个原则有多重要呢？
And how important is this principle?
回到马太福音的五章里面，你。
When we read Matthew chapter 5.
主耶稣告诉我们说，你要严加的处理，你要很严厉的去处理。
Jesus demands us to treat this matter very seriously.
所以从二十九节他开始讲。
Therefore, from verse 29,
你的右眼叫你跌倒，你要把它挖出来丢掉啊。
He said, if your right eye causes you to sin, pluck it out and cast it from you.
如果你的手、哦、白体中的一体宁可失去，你要、把它哪一个都好，把它砍了、哦、免得你、好过你、下地狱、啊、
And if your right hand or any other body part causes you to sin, cut it off, lest your whole body is cast into hell.
那主耶稣这个话是什么意思呢？
So what did Jesus mean by saying this?
那万一我们控制不住有淫念怎么办？要把眼睛挖出来吗？
What happens if we have these desires that we can't control? Do we really gouge out our eyes?
主耶稣当然不是叫我们按着字句去理解了。
Jesus does not want us to take this literally.
我们知道主耶稣要强调的是我们要严厉的对付罪啊。
But what Jesus wants us to uphold is this very very strict way to deal with sin.
你否则你就会失去一个救恩，他警告你啊。
Because Jesus wants us that we might lose our salvation if we don't.
你砍手也没有用的，因为你的心没有解决啊。
So what if you cut off your hand if the issue is still in your heart?
当然，如果是这样，基督徒会成为残废了。
If this was meant to be taken literally, then Christians will all be handicapped.
那要也就是说，无论你付上多大的代价、痛苦，你总之你就是不要去犯这样的淫乱的啊，这种淫念的奸淫的罪。
So the point is that even if you have to pay a heavy price, or you have to sacrifice a lot, it is still worth it to get rid of the problem of sin.
因为罪会使你失去救恩啊。
Because sin will cause you to lose your salvation.
从另外一个角度去思考。
And from another perspective.
我们每个人都爱惜自己的眼睛啊。
All of us, we treasure our own eyes.
如果有人要把你的眼睛挖掉。
If someone wants to gouge out your eyes.
你肯定愿意放弃一切，也不要失去你的眼睛啊。
You will surely give up everything so that you will not lose your eyes.
所以我们为了不犯罪，甚至要放弃你最珍爱的眼睛啊。
So therefore, if you do not want to sin, it might entail you losing the eyes which you so desire.
这就是告诉我们说，那个代价不管多大，你都要去对付它，你不能允许它发生啊。
So what this means for us is that even we have to pay a great price, we have to do it so that we will not allow sin to happen.
没有什么比对付罪更重要的了。
There's nothing more important than to address the problem of sin.
不管你要承受多大的痛苦，你还是要对付它。
No matter how much pain you have to bear, you have to tackle it.
那我们知道重新来控制我们自己，而且节制是救恩的一个很重要的关键哦。
So, controlling our hearts, having self-control, self-discipline, it is very important for our salvation.
所以保罗他就是讲了，我攻克己身，叫身服我。
And therefore, Paul also said that he disciplined his body, and bring it into subjection.
这就是我们基督徒要小心的哈。
So this is something which Christians we have to be careful.
有时候人、在一种状态里面就很 不警醒、不留意的时候，你看大卫。
Sometimes human beings, when we are put in situations where we do not pay attention, for example, David.
他敬畏神啊。
David feared God.
可是你看到他很奇怪。
But yet it is very strange.
他不是没有妻子、没有妃嫔啊。
It is not that he did not have any wives.
旧约并没有真正的去禁止他。
And the Old Testament, there were no laws that restricted him.
可是他偏偏就是要去找别人的妻子。
But yet he still went to find other wives.
所以就算你有妻子，也不能停止让你去犯这种罪啊。
Or to find someone else's wife. So even though you may be married, it does not mean that you will no longer commit this sin.
有些人以为说，我没有结婚，所以我才会犯这种罪，还是没有这样啊。但是有了妻子的，他这么多妻子还是会去犯。
So we see that even a person who has many wives will still will still commit this sin of marrying even more wives.
所以我们这些神的话对我们的警告，我们真的要留意哈。
Therefore, we have to take heed to these warnings that God has given us.
那我想，我第二部分要留在还有第二集跟大家来探讨另外一个问题啊，跟关于不可奸淫的问题。
So this is only part one of my sermon. In part two of my sermon on you shall not commit adultery.
当然如果有去我讲，我至少讲了四篇关于诫命的道理了。
I have so far, thus far spoken. Four sermons concerning the Ten Commandments.
第一个是在我以外不可有别的神，第一条诫命，对不对？
The first sermon in the series, is the first commandment. You shall have no other gods, before me.
那我也讲过不可偷盗。
I talk about you shall not steal.
哦，也讲过不可作假见证。
And another sermon on you shall not bear false witness.
那这些诫命呢？其实我要强调的一个观念就是什么呢
？So what? Do I really want to emphasize when I share about these commandments?、
哦、因为这些自由神学主义的人，还是说这些谈爱的基督徒
？So, there are Christians who have been influenced by liberal theology, and when they talk about love.
他们会忽略一个很重要的观念
they neglect something which is very important.
他们会以为说神的诫命是没有界限的
They would say that God's commandments they are unconditional.
No, without a line.
Or they do not have any line or boundaries.
而为什么他们会这样看呢
Why do they view it that way?
因为圣经里面的确有一些特殊的例子
Because there are some exceptional examples.
比如大卫犯奸淫啊，他没有死啊。
For example, David committed adultery, he did not die.
但是是否这样特殊的例子就是变成一个普通的例子呢
？But then, do we take these exceptions as the norm?
你会说神是公义的。
We say that God is just, he's righteous.
神会原谅大卫，一定也会原谅其他的人。
If God will forgive David, he will surely forgive every other person.
是的，神原谅了大卫。
Yes, God indeed forgave David.
但你犯这个罪的人是不是大卫呢
？But, you who had committed the sin, are you David?
我们要清楚地明白，神在处理每一件事情的时候，会看一个人的动机，还有他的背景。
We need to understand, that God, handles each matter individually because He considers, their motives and the circumstances.
而且神在审判的时候，他也有他的公义的标准的。
And God, when He judges man, He has, He adheres to His righteous standards.
如果我们认定大卫这个特殊的例子是神公义的一面
if we ascertain, God's, judgment on David as representative of God's justice.
所以这个公义应该要实行在其他人的身上。
Therefore, this same form of justice or righteousness will also be to all other men.
那我告诉你，神不公义的。
Then I will tell you that then it means that God is not just,
he's not fair. 因为神在旧约也判一些犯这样的罪人死的。
Because within the same Old Testament, God had also judged others who had done the same sin and with death.
对不对？非哈尼不是去杀了那些去跟那些外邦女子犯淫乱的吗
？For example, Phinehas, who stabbed the man who committed sexual immorality with a Gentile.
所以要探讨这个问题，我们必须深入去了解。圣经是怎么样看待这些诫命的
？So therefore, we need to examine the Bible. How does the Bible view these people who broke the commandments?
解经要有一个原则的
We need to be principled when we explain the Bible.
第一个，圣经不会矛盾的。
First principle is that the Bible will not contradict itself.
那特殊的例子不要把它当成一个常态。
Second, we cannot take the exceptions as the norm.
如果是这样。十字架的贼不用洗礼，今天所有人都不用洗礼了。
Because we can say that since the thief, the burglar on the cross, did not have to be baptized to be saved, therefore no one needs to be baptized to be saved.
而我们读圣经也要有一种正确的观念。
When we read the Bible, we need to have, we need to approach it with a correct understanding.
那些我们能够明白的，我们要去留意。
We need to pay attention, to what we.
我们明白的，圣经很清楚的。
To the things that the Bible is clear about and we understand clearly.
但是那些不清楚的，我们不要去推论出自己的一个观念。
But as for those which may not be very clear, we should not
speculate
and come up with our own examples.
但是圣经其实是有给我们答案的，但是我们要把它融会贯通，把它看明。
The Bible will provide us with answers, but we have to understand the Bible as a whole, and then we derive an explanation.
所以神的诫命我们要谨慎。
Therefore, we have to be watchful when it comes to keeping God's commandments.
因为审判人的是神，不是人。
Because it is not man who will judge man, but it is God who will judge.
那如果我们错误的解释，我们就会要付上错误的代价。
Therefore, if we explain it with error. If you explain the commandments with error, then we would have.
我们就留到下一讲。
Pay the price.
我们就留到下一次再讲。我们来唱诗。
So we'll continue next time in part 2. Now we shall sing our closing hymn.
228首。
228.